motivation is tied up in your feelings, you've missed it. Let's think about that for a minute. The motivation of the prize of the high calling of God does not change. It is literally like black and white. It is as real as a newspaper page. It doesn't change. That's facts, facts, facts. What changes is our feelings. So if our motivation changes with the wind like our feelings do, can I get an amen? When mom is in a mood, you better just go to your room, all right? It'll be over in about 30 minutes. Just take a breath, everybody. I'm just saying, let's just be real in here today. But if your motivation is attached to your feelings, you've got a problem you need to be aware of. That the motivation doesn't change because Christ Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He does not change with the shifting sand. James chapter 1 says, when you ask me for something, don't doubt like the waves of the sea tossed back and forth by the wind, but ask in belief. Let's have a belief so deeply rooted in us that our motivation is out there. And when we're straining toward that prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus because he doesn't change. We do. We're the ones that miss the mark. We're the ones that keep going back over here to the past and picking up all that stuff that hurt us and taking it with us over here to this place where we're supposed to be focused on what he's got for us. The persistence of the press has to override our feelings. The persistence of the press and the power that he gives us has to override all the doubts and insecurities and mental distress and battles of the mind that we face every single day. You're gonna have to press to get there. Because here's the thing, the world is against you. Have you figured that out yet, teenagers? The world is against you, right? You're gonna come places like this, you're gonna find encouragement, you're gonna find hope, you're gonna find light. The world is against you. The words of others are gonna be against you. Don't let that play up in your mind and set up shop and now define you forever. The weakness of your flesh is against you. Does anybody know what I mean about that? The weakness of your flesh, meaning you're your own worst enemy at times. Nobody else has to really be present there. You just got it going on with yourself, right? That's hard stuff.